urban growth analysis is highly relevant for different tasks, which may go from research studies to the design of public policy and monitoring sustainable development indicators. It is of particular interest to study the relationship between urban growth with other development indicators, such as gross domestic product, often called GDP. In this work, we explore city growth by exploiting Landsat geomedian images with data science technique. The population of our cities has had a considerable increase over the past 30 years. Back in 1990, according to the Housing and Population Census, Mexico's urban population was close to 58 million people. However, years later, as of 2018, the National Council of Population, CONAPO, estimates the number of people living in urban areas is over 92 million. We can take the particular case of Aguascalientes City as an example, where we can see a very noticeable growth when comparing Landsat geomedian image from year 1989 with the one from 2018. The question arises to whether it is possible to automatically identify urban growth. As we look for the answer, we first needed to identify human settlements. For this purpose, we use the National Address Number database. This database was built with domicile registers and was last updated in 2012, including more than 30 million numbers, which are distributed all over the Mexican territory. Our study is implemented as follows. First, as 1 square kilometer grid is defined over the country, the address density is computed for each cell in the grid. This density value is computed with the average of neighbors within a 50-meter radius. Observing the density distribution of address numbers, it is now possible to identify settlements with a high density of homes and those with a lower density. And once the urban areas have been identified, we are able to match cells from the 1 square kilometer grid from the 2012 geomedian image to its corresponding urban, semi-urban, and non-urban areas. Next, applying machine learning techniques, we can replicate the identification of patterns found in the 2012 image to the images from the rest of the years. Those images undergo a feature extraction process that will facilitate this task. Also, a sample of previously tagged images as urban, non-urban, or semi-urban accordingly was split into the training and testing dataset. The training dataset is used to teach the algorithm correct examples for it to characterize and identify those features that determine each of the three classes. Once this is done, the algorithm is used in the testing dataset to evaluate how well the algorithm learned and recognized each class. This way, it is possible to measure its accuracy. Finally, once an adequate performance is achieved, all unlabeled images can be classified for each of the annual Landsat geomedian, which go from 1989 to 2019. As a result, we can trace urban growth throughout time in different regions of the country. We consider the region of El Bajío is a relevant example to show the potential of our works. Since the early 90s, there has been sustained support in the region for the development of the automotive industry. Therefore, in recent years, this region has had the highest economic growth of the country. When we analyzed El Bajío's both urban and GDP growth, we found a consistently matching behavior. This outcome is further corroborated by graphing the two variables and analyzing their scatter diagrams. Three cases were analyzed and a high correlation was found on each case. These results show the usefulness of automatic analysis of satellite images to understand the territory's changes and their link to other variables. Predictions made by machine learning can serve as input for the generation of indicators that allow us to measure, among many other things, progress towards goals of sustainable development.